It is impossible to talk about seeking the Lord without talking about turning from sin. It is impossible to talk about turning to the Lord without turning away from iniquity and wickedness. Clearly, this is an essential in the gospel message. Let me help you a little bit with that. Go to the New Testament. Let's look at Matthew chapter 3, and I want to give you kind of a fast look at critical scriptures just to plant in your mind the importance of this doctrine. John the Baptist came in Matthew 3, verse 1. This is what he preached: repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent. And this is the one referred to by Isaiah the prophet, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, make ready the way of the Lord, make his path straight. If you're going to receive the Lord and the salvation he brings, you're going to have to straighten out. You're going to have to make a way for the Lord. We looked at that this morning, as it's indicated from the lips of John the Baptist in Luke chapter 3, where he quotes the extended portion of Isaiah 40, verses 3 and 4, about lifting up the low places, lowering the high places, straightening the crooked places, and cleaning the rough places. There is some hard work to be done in order to enter the kingdom. That was the message of John the Baptist. Down in verse 8, he then adds, therefore, bring forth fruit in keeping with repentance. Demonstrate that your repentance is real. In the fourth chapter of Matthew, Jesus began to preach, just as John had said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Salvation is near. We talked about that this morning, salvation and the kingdom, kingdom of God, kingdom of heaven, same thing. Virtually the same. Salvation and the kingdom are the same. Salvation is at hand if you repent. We find this note sounded repeatedly in the ministry of our Lord as well. In the ninth chapter of Matthew, verse 12, Jesus said, it's not those who are healthy who need a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire compassion and not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners. And the other gospels add to repentance. He has come to call sinners to repentance, and that will show up in the other gospels. Just to parallel that, Mark 1:14, again, the emphasis is clearly John preaching, and then John being taken into custody in Mark 1:14. Jesus comes into Galilee preaching the gospel of God, the good news from heaven, the good news of God. What is it? The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Repent and believe in the gospel. We talk a lot about believing. We don't talk a lot about repentance. But this is absolutely critical. In the second chapter of Mark, again, this message comes through. As I read you earlier in Matthew, here Mark adds this account to his own record. It is not those who are healthy who need a physician, but those who are sick. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners. Same statement repeated there as we read in Matthew. In the sixth chapter of Mark and the 12th verse, here we find the 12, the apostles, set out to preach, and they went out, Mark 6:12, and preached that men should repent. That, of course, is the mandate. And remember Luke, if you will, for just a moment, Luke 5, 31 and 32, because this same emphasis is made there. In Luke 5, 31, Jesus said, it's not those who are well who need a physician, those who are sick. I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners, and here it comes, to repentance. Called people to repent. Jesus called people to repent. The apostles called people to repent. Now let's go to 13 in Luke, a familiar chapter to us now because we've been dealing with it for some weeks. In Luke 13, you remember in verse 3, I tell you no, unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. Luke 13, 5, I tell you no, unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. There is no salvation apart from repentance. Go to the 15th chapter.